Catcher, number 22, Tom Rex. 7. Number 38, Zete Blasto. Number 39, Mike Walker. Number 42, Randy Hero. Number 47, Miguel Garcia. The manager of the Buffalo Bisons, number 2, Terry Collins. And number 41, the coach, Jackie Brown. The trainer of the Bisons, Carlos Ledesma.
Exciting. And then 72, the All-Star game, and then getting traded to Philadelphia and being a part of some of their accomplishments. But 69, they say the first one's always the best, so I don't know. I would be reluctant to say that, but you can't be any more thrilled than we were at that time.
Talking to Svoboda.
Me to be a stopper in the bullpen for him and to forget about ever starting again. And I said, Gil, well, you know more about baseball than I do. If you think that's the job that I should do on this ball club, then I'll do it. Mm-hmm. And he told me that I could make a better contribution to the team. He said I could have a better career and I'd make more money. And what else criteria do you need?
Made throughout your years, and it's going on 30 years that I've been in professional baseball, and at the back end, you see your old friends and a lot of guys you room with, you played against, and it's just a great deal of excitement for us. And really to get the chance to perform again, even though you know that you're not anywhere close to what you used to be, but you still, the adrenaline starts flowing, the excitement's there for you. You hope to get a base hit and you don't foul up the ball game.
Say hi or hello.
That
sounds too affectionate.
No.
This is the Mad Hungarian, 96 Rock, KSHE Radio in St. Louis. But when I'm in Buffalo and I want to rock and roll, it's on 97 Rock.
The September of 1967 was as good a month of pitching as I ever had. You know, I never had things go so right for so long a period of time.
Who were you with then?
Minnesota. Unfortunately, that year I hurt my arm the second of the last game of the season. The Red Sox beat us in that last weekend. But, I was like 7-0 in September with about a ERA in the high ones or something for that month. So that's a good month for
me. On the tickets, you know, like anything resembling Major League Baseball is purely coincidental. That would have been fair, you know. They were terrible. They were terrible. They were a bunch of has-beens and never-will-bes. I mean, that's what they had. They were trying to, early on in the franchise, 63 or 65 or so, they were really trying to bring back some of the older guys that had some appeal in New York. And they, to me, they weren't at all committed towards anything respectable like winning. Really, until after that period of time. And I think later on when they got Hodges there, and you know, you could see the organization building with talent. Whitey Herzog is handling the minor league system. Shoot, we had a lot of, we had ability down there, and the team started to come together, and it came together rather quickly.
What was it like being traded to the New York Yankees going across town?
Well, I was traded from the Mets to Montreal for half a season, so it was like being allowed to escape limbo after about a half a season.
I got a million of them. I don't make, you know, I always say, sticks and stones might break my bone, and words will never harm.
That's right. Now,
why would such an outstanding individual and the ball player that you were be tagged with a nickname, Old Ace of Base?
Well, you see, when I played for the White Sox, we just had nothing to play and had to play hurt all the time. See, I broke my leg and last day before the spring training, played 94 ball games. And then I get hurt. I had 17 stitches up the back of my leg. And I played every day. And all of the stitches broke out.
Wow, that's...
Remember about it?
Yeah.
Very competitive player.
Now stepping in the American League.
Played basically the same way. We played to win. He was a winner. And just all around, he's a good guy.
What type of presence was he in the locker
room? There are times in every single year that you play when you're unconscious and you can't do anything wrong. You see the ball and you wait real good on it and you just do everything right. I don't know what the explanation is for it or why that happens. I don't have the slightest clue why that happens. One time against Kansas City in a four-game series against Kansas City, I think I started it off with 11 RBIs and a doubleheader and three home runs. And I did that three times in a game. But I think in that whole series, I drove in something like 16 runs in a four-game series. Something like that. So, you know, that was a pretty good streak right there. It's kind of hard to, you know, remember. I remember being hot and catching on fire, but nothing, you know, nothing really spectacular.
Good pitching and not too much hitting it.
How did you feel the next day after playing a full
season? I had a problem because I went into the all-time leader and muscle. In seven innings, I thought I would start the game and play maybe three innings and be out of there. And I played the whole ball game. And in fact, I think I set a record for most putouts at first base in an All-Star game.
What did you feel like the next day?
I was pretty stiff and sore.
Last question. I don't know if you know, ESPN is bringing back the old show Home Run Derby.
Aaron was the guy that won all the money on that show. I won the most games. I remember hitting against Rocky Colabino. I think Mays beat me in the bottom of the ninth. I beat Mickey Mantle in the game. So it was a lot of fun a long time ago, and I'm glad to bring it back.
1960.
Old Wrigley Field, how they were back then as to what they are now is all a different difference. You have to allow another 40 years on top of that. So quite a difference in time.
Is the game different today?
Not per se, no. The equipment is different. You got big gloves. I don't see how they can miss a ball today. And then they shouldn't have that big glove. But the only thing I would say is different today is probably in better condition. And they're making a lot more money. The talent may not be there, but there's a lot more money there.
Are the umpires too these days?
Oh, no umpires, no. The umpires are necessary evils. We're out there because we have to be out there. Nobody appreciates you. And we know that. As an umpire, you know that. And you play with the punches, you know. You're not going to satisfy. You get 50,000 people. You're not going to satisfy. You got 50 ball players, 25 on each side. You're going to satisfy one team, maybe not the other team. And who cares? When I walk out on the field, I want to satisfy myself deep down in my heart. If I get that, I'm satisfied.
The Elks played in Kansas City for 2 years. Almost got hit in the head, and then Casey said, move something by your glove. You learn how to play first base.
Now, you managed, though, despite the back problem, you managed the bat over 305 times. Was it just a situation of handling the pain after a while and then dealing with the back problem?
Oh, no, I hurt my back in 1957. We lost the Milwaukee Braves. But I had a brace. I played with a corset on for a couple of years, but it didn't bother me. Everything's fine. I made a mistake picking up an air conditioner. And everybody crucified me. They don't know. The manager made me play, and I played every inch of it. So I was was always afraid to lose my job.
Great, one of the greatest teams ever to hit the field. What do you remember? There's so many things that happened that season, the 61 homers. Do you remember the pressure that Roger Maris was under?
Well, it was the greatest team that I played with. We hit 240 home runs, and we didn't have a designated hitter. Roger died 4 years ago. Elson Howard died 6 years ago. To me, it was a great club. We had a lot of togetherness. There was nobody jealous of one another. We all played to win a pennant, and we had a great year. All of us had a great year at the same time.
Now, despite the greatness that everyone remembers about the hitting, that club had some pretty doggone good pitching, too, as well.
Oh, well, we had Whitey, John Marshall, Tom Turley, Joe Stanford, Art Dittmer. We had a great pitching staff. It just everybody's jealous. Everybody had a good year.
You guys must have really felt for Roger, though, that season, with the amount of pressure that fell on the media, just pounding the ball.
The media crucified the guy. He was a hell of a complete ball player, and we all respected him as a team player. But he got in trouble with one sports writer, and this writer just blasted Roger, and everybody took it from there. But to us, he was a hell of a player.
In 63,
I don't know. I think it has its good points, and I think probably has some bad points to it. The good point is that if a guy's pitching a real good ball game, and he's 1-1, he doesn't get pinch hit for and doesn't get a chance maybe not to win the ball game. He's in there for a little bit longer. The bad part is probably the strategy changes some, and you don't have to think about it a whole lot of who you're going to pinch hit for the pitcher and get your team prepared for whatever's going to come in the later innings.
Thank you very much.
$50,000 going up to baseball players. I'm talking about guys who played in the 30s, the 40s, the 50s, right up through the 80s.
Pirates, number 8, Willie Stargell.
fielding records too numerous to list save one, the highest career fielding percentage for any third baseman ever. He became only the 14th player in the history of the game to be voted into the Hall of Fame in his first year of eligibility. Formerly with the Baltimore Orioles, number 5, Brooks Robinson.
First dramatic ninth inning home run off Ralph Terry. They brought the Pirates their first world championship in 35 years. Known as the quickest hand to the pivot on the double play. From the Pirates, number 9, Bill Mazeroski.
Selected to the All-Star team in his first 8 full seasons in the majors as a rookie in 1964 and captured Rookie of the Year honors. He won 2 batting titles in 1965 and 1971 and was also awarded a gold glove in 1966. From the Minnesota Twins, number 6, Tony Oliva. He remained a consistent long ball threat, collecting 374 homers and 1,159 RBIs. From the Indians, Tigers, A's, White Sox, Dodgers, and Yankees, number 7, The Rock, Rocky Colavito.
Of the year 1964, he was named the American League's MVP in 1972 after leading the league in homers with 37. RBI mark with 113. He reached the 30 homer mark 6 times and hit over 307 times during his career. From the Phillies, Cardinals, Dodgers, White Sox, and Athletics, number 15, Dick Allen. Royals and Houston Colts 45s, number 15, Jerry Brody.
Rangers and Pirates, number 11, Jim Fregosi.
Phillies and Houston. He finished his career with 286 career homers, including 9 seasons with 20 or more. Please welcome outfielder Frank Thomas.
This catcher was named to the American League All-Star team 9 consecutive years and won 5 gold gloves during his career. His career fielding percentage of .993 is a major league record for catchers. He hit 25 homers and drove in 84 runs for the 1968 World Champion Tigers.
Cards to a World Series championship over the Yankees. In the next 14 years, he hit 300 or better 7 times and finished his career with more than 3,000 hits. But it was his base running for which he was most feared. In 19 years, he stole 938 bases, an all-time record. Always the money player from the Cubs and Cardinals, number 20, Lou Brock.
American League All-Star, this former first baseman hit double figures in home runs 10 times, including 28 home runs in 1961. A major leaguer for 14 seasons, his finest season came in 1954 when he hit 3 Sox and Angels, number 14, Bill Moose Scarrow.
First up, number 23, Johnny Logan.
Seasons, this Hall of Fame pitcher was known for his excellence in postseason play, a record 146 World Series innings. He holds 8 series records, including wins and strikeouts, and pitched 33 and two-thirds consecutive scoreless series innings. He won the Cy Young Award in 1961 and the all-time Yankees leader in games, innings, wins, strikeouts, shutouts, and earned run average. He was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 1974. From the New York Yankees, 16, the chairman of the board, Ed Whitey Ford.
game with the Chicago Cubs. It's a National League record of 1,117 games in a row. He averaged more than 180 hits a year for 12 seasons and hit more than 30 homers in 5 different years. 1961's National League Rookie of the Year and a 4-time starter on the National League All-Star Team. Formerly with the Cubs and A's as an outfielder, Hall of Famer number 26, Billy Williams.
Strikeouts, earning All-Star status as well in 1967. He reached double figures in wins 8 times and struck out 100 or more batters 9 times. From the Red Sox, Brewers, and Phillies, number 16, Jim Lundmore.
This pitcher was named to the American League All-Star team in 1943 pitches during his 12-year career. He also holds a season record for being hit by 50 pitches in 1971. He hit over 364 in 1973. From the Mets, Dodgers, Giants, Expos, and Cardinals, welcome number 33, Ron Hunt.
'68. He earned the Sporting News Comeback Player of the Year Award in 1979. From the Tigers, Rangers, Indians, Athletics, Blue Jays, and Mariners, number 23, Willie Horton.
'74 and 1979. Member of the National League All-Star Team 4 times, as well as the American League once. He's 12th on the all-time victory list with 318. From the Braves, Yankees, Indians, and Blue Jays, number 35, Phil Niekro.
Place on the all-time victory list with 300 wins. A winner of 20 or more games 5 times. He captured the Cy Young Award in 1959 after finishing the season at 22-10. He was an American League All-Star 6 times. He holds the AL record for most years pitched with 23. From the Senators, Indians, and White Sox, number 24, Early Wynn.
This former major leaguer was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 1976. He led the National League in wins in 1950 through 55 and won 20 or more games 6 times. Named the Major League Player of the Year in 1952, he averaged 18 wins in his first 12 seasons in the majors. His best season came in 1952 when he finished 28-7 with an ERA of 2.59. From the Phillies, Orioles, Astros, and Cubs, number 36, Robin Roberts.
Drove in 114 runs and posted a .297 batting average, averaging 23 home runs in 15 full seasons, a 2nd all-time leading home run hitter. From the Orioles, Indians, and Dodgers, the pride of Key West, Florida, John Wesley Boog Powell.
Royals and Braves, number 39, Al Hrabowski. This left-handed pitcher saved 20 or more games. He finished with an ERA of under 2.0 3 times and was selected to the National League All-Star Team in 1972 and 1975. From the Mets and the Phillies, welcome number 45, Tug McGraw.
Still there. You know what? No. Dad.
I'm sure everybody's up there.
Shortstop, number four, Luke Appling.
Voy firmando bola.
Bueno, caballo.
Está bueno eso hasta los pocos ahí.
Bueno, y no por ahí, ¿cómo puedo hacer
coño? Si
ya trabaja Guillermo para acá.
Guillermo, para que tirara clásico.
Where's your sister?
North Eastern and Central Pennsylvania. You have to talk about two starters for the National League tonight. Keith Miller on my right from the Red Barons. Tom O'Malley, the Tidewater Tide.
And from Buffalo, the Pittsburgh Pirates. This is shortstop Jay Bell.
Oh, yeah, to come here to Columbus and play with all these other great players from all over the country, it's just a really big honor for me.
Is there pressure in a game like tonight's game for you as an athlete?
I think so. You know, it's a chance for a lot of different people, different scouts to look at you. It's on a national cable, you know, TV, so, you know, it's a lot of pressure, but you have to, you know, look at it as just another game.
We appreciate you tonight. You are the only man here to ever play in last year's All-Star game. It's got to be a kick for you as well.
Oh, I mean, the second time around is even more of a thrill. It's, you know, the atmosphere here is very exciting, and we're just happy again to be here, and hopefully I can contribute to the team.
And it's got to be special to be going back home once again.
Oh, that's for sure. You know, we're happy about that, and hopefully we'll continue.
Tom, the best of luck to you tonight, and tremendous success.
They're going to change Dublin over to
Burkerville. You hear that? Maybe once a year.
Once a year, that's it, huh?
Whenever I come in. The Stars of the Future. The National League against the American League in the second year for the same format. In fact, the Pacific Coast League, the International League, and the American Association have come together to give us truly the cream of the crop in AAA baseball. Kim Singleton will be handling the expert commentary on the ball game tonight, and if anybody has great appreciation for the city of Columbus and this ballpark, it's this gentleman, because he played your last minor league game here and brought it to the Mets from Columbus.
Columbus, Ohio, went to Chicago to join the Mets. It was a very special night. I talked to everything that talked to me. The next time I talked to was over, but Chuck Miller told me I was on my way.
Didn't really have any bags to pack, but he headed to the bigs, and he was there to stay. Third man on the telecast tonight will be handling both dugouts and anything else that goes on down here on the field of Cooper Stadium tonight during this All-Star ball game. He's Joe Buck, and he's going to number the players down. Joe?
Mostly,
From Richmond, infielder Mark Lemke of the Atlanta Braves,
mostly, hitting 253,
3 homers,
I don't know what happened after that,
RBIs.
You know. And you know, I don't decide who's gonna get picked in this, and you know, I don't have any control about it. You know, I shouldn't throw anything. I mean, I said anything. You know, I feel like I have the numbers. You know, to be here anyway.
Indianapolis's Jeff Houston of the Montreal.
Did it cross your mind not to?
you say, well,
well he crossed my mind, but he's not the right height to take it, you know.
Runs 37 RBIs.
Greg, last year was a double-A All-Star game.
Parents and all my friends back home didn't get to see me play in double-A All-Star game. They'll be watching tonight, so, and all my buddies back home down at Shaky's Pizza and my teammates back in Denver, so I got to do something tonight.
Folks, remember these two names and faces, Todd Zeal of Louisville, Greg Vaughn of Denver, two Major League superstars just waiting their chance to shine. Good luck tonight, fellas. Back to you, Ron.
I knew that I was supposed to be doing the opening shot for this game. Because we've played against each other all 3 years. Greg and so I knew that.
From Tidewater, the New York Mets, infielder Tom O'Malley.
Guys, you know, they say this is going to be, second base, you know, for the next 3, 4, 5 years.
Yeah.
But I think sooner or later, you know, with the year I have, I think that I have to make it.
Yeah.
What is that?
What I asked for, I mean, you get to be every day.
Well, I said, you know, this is like a little bit pressing here. Totally 300, you know, and see, you know, if somebody's winning, you know, it's an opportunity to prepare on another.
Yeah.
But,
the voice of this week in baseball, the one, the only, the incomparable, Mr. Bill Allen.
Played in the majors from 1975 to 1981, Pete McCannon. The National League coaches representing batting average and stolen bases, shortstop Jeff Fuson. Triple A baseball with a batting average of .393. How about it? Designated hitter Junior Noboa. Mark Lemke. expanding force of the AAA Alliance, catcher Todd Zeal. Among the Pacific Coast League leaders in average and stolen bases, center fielder Mike Huff, the Dukes and the Dodgers, the leading strikeout pitcher in AAA baseball, Raymond Martinez. Coast League most valuable player, catcher Sandy Alomar. Hit a home run off third fly Lovin in his very first major league at bat. Infielder Jay Bell. Bisons, a 12-year Major League veteran. Designated hitter Steve Henderson. Also from the Bisons, the 1988 American Dorn Taylor. From the Iowa Cubs and Chicago Cubs, tied for the victory lead in the American Association, pitcher Kevin Blankenship. From the Indianapolis Indians and Montreal Expos, a 10-game winner and American Association ERA leader, pitcher Mark Gardner. From the Richmond Braves and Atlanta Braves, one of the top strikeout pitchers in AAA baseball, pitcher Tommy Green. Also from the Richmond Braves, this player leads the International League in strikeouts. He's a native of Dublin. From the Tucson Toros and Houston Astros, catcher Carl Nichols. From the Albuquerque Dukes and Dodgers, he's among the home run leaders in the Coast League, outfielder Javier Ortiz. From the Phoenix Fire Saves thus far in 1989, pitcher Stuart Tate, and the trainer. American League coaches representing the stolen base leader, center fielder Lance Johnson, batting second. Representing the Columbus Clippers and Yankees, third leading hitter in the International League at 312, first baseman Al Morris. Zephyrs and Milwaukee Brewers, the American Association home run leader with 19, left fielder Greg Vaughn. The AAA RBI League designated hitter Jim Wilson, batting fifth. Representing the Columbus Clippers and Yankees, the leading hitter, in the International League with an average of 331, right fielder Kevin Moss. Chiefs and Toronto Blue Jays, he's been among the International League leaders in average and RBIs all season, catcher Francisco Cabrera. Association leaders in home runs and RBIs, third baseman Scott Kubal. Batting eighth, representing the Columbus Clippers and the Yankees. Among the International League leaders in home runs and RBIs, presenting shortstop Randy Velarde. Batting ninth, representing the Denver Zephyrs, Milwaukee Brewers, an All-America from the University of Texas, second baseman Billy Bates. And the starting pitcher for the American League, representing the Vancouver Canadiens and the Chicago White Sox. And by the way, he's thrown back-to-back no-hitters this season. Pitcher Tom Dreeves. Now the American League reserves. Luka from the Columbus Clippers and Yankees League with 10. Catcher Brian Dorsey. From the Pawtucket Red Sox and Boston Red Sox. From Tacoma Rangeland, pitcher Brian Clark. From the Edmonton Trappers and California Angels, a career 288 hitter. Infielder Pete Coachman. Butch Davis from the Syracuse Chiefs and Ben Allen Hill. From the Colorado Springs Sky Sox and Cleveland Indians, the Coast League's leader in saves with 19, pitcher Steve Olin. From the Vancouver Canadiens and Chicago White Sox, he leads the Coast League in earned run average at 2.26, pitcher Adam Peterson. From the Portland Beavers and Minnesota Twins, he's among the top 10 hitters in the Coast League, infielder Vic Rodriguez. From the Toledo Mudheads and Detroit Tigers, has pitched in the major leagues with the Red Sox, Mariners, and Tigers, pitcher Mike Trujillo.
Baseman from the Nashville Sounds, number 18, Scotty Madison. The right fielder from the Keith Miller. Thank you. Getting off for the American and from the Oklahoma City 89ers. From the Louisville Redbirds, the catcher, number 7, Todd Zeal. Thank you.
Thank you.